Good day, everyone. My name is Ejimnkeonye Doris Dora from Nigerian Korean Model School. I'm presenting a paper presentation on the topic development of multimedia based supplementary teaching material. Multimedia-based supplementary teaching material. I'm going to be talking on the introduction to the topic, the meaning of some terms like teaching aids, multimedia itself, the meaning of supplementary teaching aids, the uses of supplementary teaching material, developing supplementary teaching material, conclusion and recommendation. In the introduction, this topic aims at the creation of the use of supplementary teaching material, adding to multimedia material itself. Now, when we make use of teaching materials, it makes teaching effective and efficient and good delivery. The pupils learning or the learners themselves will take home and assimilate the lesson taught. When creating teaching aids, they are effectively used depending on how you present the lesson. The learning process is enhanced and the instructor or the teacher or the impactor has less talk to make because a well-planned teaching aid has spoken all of whatever you want to teach. Meaning of teaching aids. Teaching aids are materials. They are sources. They are supports. They are assisting gadgets. They are used in teaching to make it effective and teaching well delivered. Teaching aid can be in different forms, such as live specimen. The live specimen I mean here are not the ones that are harmful. Like you cannot get a live snake into the class. It will be scary and it's harmful. We have concrete objects, visual objects, still pictures, flashcards, tangible materials. All these enhance support in learning. Multimedia. Multimedia from the word media. Media is a communication outlet. They are the tools that are used to store and deliver information. We have radio, television, etc. Now multimedia. What do we mean by multimedia? Multimedia means the combination of these medias to convey information. They are often packaged in CD-ROM, that is compact disc, the read-only memory, with link to the internet. These media combined together are text, audios, images, graphics, animations, videos, name them. The meaning of supplementary teaching materials. Now, the meaning of this means they are the added values, the added multimedias, the added teaching aids, the added teaching supports that are brought together to make teaching effective. These aids are what the learners need to learn with. They learn on a fair level with their peers. They are substitute materials or supports provided in regular education classes. If I may illustrate, it's like adding salt to make the taste of Maggi tasteful in soups. You know, we all know that Maggi tastes like salt. So when we add Maggi to the taste of salt, it brings us good seasoning taste. Supplementary materials include primary database. This primary database helps to increase the research made during lesson. Video clips, and emissions, experimental data, supplementary figures and tables, even softwares are all supplementary teaching materials. Now, uses of supplementary teaching materials, how do we make use of? What are the uses? Why do we make use of them? One, it increases the quality of experience in learning. When one uses these supplementary teaching materials, it makes you believe what you see. Because already you are seeing all this, you'll be told that this is this and this is that. With your eyes, visual gift, you'll be able to find out that this is what they are talking about. Two, it increases learners' perception of important information. Three, it motivates learners. How can we use it to motivate learners? Maybe in a long or lengthy lecture, the learners may be tired of listening. We can use these supplementary teaching materials to cheer them up, to make them feel that they are learning. How do we do it? We can insert video, YouTube video. This video necessarily must not be focused on whatever you're teaching, though it may have part of whatever you're teaching, but let it be based on something like fun or entertainment to cheer them up again. So when you find out that their interest is back, then you put on with the lesson and continue with the lesson. Let me give you an instance of this illustration. When you have slides in presentation, you know, in presentation, in PPT, we make use of slides. Before you start the lesson, you put up an entertaining video. It may be relating to the topic you want to take, or it may be a fun kind of video. Then when you play it for some time, you cut off and start the slide one. You talk on the slide two, you talk on the slide three. Now I'm going to slide four. You notice that some of the learners are getting tired. Then put up another YouTube video of entertainment. When you put it up, you find out that they are lively again, because some learners, especially children, they like visual aids, they like watching fun. So you put it on for them. For some minutes, you cut off, then you pick slide 5, slide 6. Then in the middle of the lesson, so at the end of the lesson, you play another entertaining video. Or even at the end of this lesson, you can insert an assignment video. They watch the video in the class and they go home and relate to the questions you may ask them after the video. It also improves organization and presentation of lesson. When you have supplementary materials, you'll be able to organize your lesson and present your lesson effectively. Now, how do we develop these supplementary materials in learning? We can get pictures from memory cards. These memory cards we use in our phones. We can get pictures from them, all these snapshots. We can get pictures from them and make use of them. We can snap teaching aids with the use of our phones, then use it as a teaching aid. Number two, we make use of visual aids. Now from the world vision, eye sighting. These are examples of visual aids. This is multimedia board. In the multimedia board, we have the chalkboard, the one we use chalk on, just as I use chalk on this. This is a multimedia board. We have the white board. It's included in the multimedia board. We have the music board. This is used in teaching the music. So we have so many boards attached to the multimedia board. This is a supplementary multimedia. Then we can also go for flashcards. We use flashcards. Cut out piece of papers, write informations, maybe spellings on of animals, you share to the class, or you display it on the post for the children to see. Maps for reading distances. You know, we cannot just teach some distances with mere verbal. You know, we have to put up this media so that they can understand what we are actually talking about. Display of posters. We have posters that we can display for them during the lesson. Bulletin board. This is an example of a bulletin board. In this bulletin board, we can see different kinds of stickers attached to the board. Then you can put up your information, whatever you want to pass, You can write them in any of these. The learners will be able to read and understand. Pointer. We make use of pointer. This pointer is used when you're making use of computer. This is a picture of a pointer. It points, it marks, it helps you to show the marks, an important item in the computer as you're making use of it. Overhead projectors. We have example of projector here. Projector is used to view whatever material you want to show to the learners. Audiovisual equipment. We have many audiovisual equipment. We can tape our lesson and bring it to the class to play for the learners to hear. We can use talking drums, wristwatches, the talking wall clocks. They are all video audiovisual equipment. Flannel board. We make use of flannel board. This is an example of a flannel board. As we can see, it's a very beautiful media that we can use to teach very young children. Very young children like pictures. They use pictures to assimilate whatever they have been taught. So we have different types of flannel board to teach children. In conclusion, the use of supplementary teaching materials or application of supplementary teaching materials aids the teaching and learning to move smoothly. It is thus important to combine media together from different sources in order to impart information and make learning efficient and effectively. In fact, more interesting. Instructors or teachers or impactors can improvise. We can improvise any of these materials and use them in learning. We can also Google on internet to finding ways of how to develop different kinds of supplementary materials to use in teaching. We can also make use of available materials around us. We have different materials around us in our homes. We have cartons. We can make shapes with cartons. We have, name it, we can use it for supplementary material during teaching. Do you know there is this belief that some learners are high-minded? High-minded in the sense that they can only understand when they see. So you have to make use of visual aids to make them understand whatever you're passing to them. While some are auditory, they are good in hearing, you know, using talking drums to talk to them, using alarms, making use of taped lesson. They can easily understand any lesson through that. Why some learners are verbal minded? They are good in talk, they are good in speech, but when you come to writing, it's difficult. So it is necessary for us to combine all this together and, you know, make all the learners learn even to the grassroots. And when they are learning, they are carried along with other peers. They enjoy the learning. They are not passive. They are not isolated. Recommendation. As a teacher in the Nigerian Korean Model School, I recommend that using supplementary materials will be effective in all schools, not only in Nigeria, but in the whole Africa. We can use it to enhance effectiveness and delivery of teaching. Learning can be done effectively too through these supplementary materials because multimedia allows learning to be more simplified. It is self-explanatory depending on how the teacher presents the lesson. It makes a learner to have a retentive memory of whatever he or she has learned, especially using the visual aids and the audiovisual aids. Moreover, do you know that these supplementary aids create a welcome back of knowledge? This knowledge that is lost during lengthy lessons, during too many talks of the teacher, during traditional way of teaching. It's this kind of bring the knowledge back and, you know, reduces a boredom. Thank you.